My name is Tobias Steinmetz, and I'm from Pottstown, Pennsylvania, born and raised. I just grew up in the same house my whole life. And my family fell away from the Lord when I was about 2 years old. So I grew up not going to church, not believing in Jesus, thinking viewing the Bible as a storybook. I was a good kid. I got good grades in school. I was in sports. I worked as soon as I could. And after graduation, I joined the Marine Corps and basically became an alcoholic afterwards. Things with relationships got worse. And when I was drinking, it opened me up to different issues. So some of our nights out, you know, would be going to the bars, going to the red light district. We just had a mentality where we work hard and we party hard. And just got, you know, caught up in that, that way of life. I got out of the Marines. And I went back home. One of my friends, you know, we were best friends since we were in diapers. I remember going out underage drinking with him, going to college parties. And he called me up, and he had gotten saved about a year before I did. And he called me up, Jesus this, Jesus that, God, God, God. And I remember thinking, like, man, I can't even talk to this guy anymore. It's just Jesus, 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 God, God, God. And he invited me to church probably about 40, 50 times, but I always had an excuse. And one night, I was supposed to have a college class, but it was canceled. He invited me to a worship service in Philadelphia. I was open to the Bible, and I go to this service, and everyone there is praising God, just saying, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Lord. So I go through the motions, and I'm doing the same exact thing. Thank you, Jesus, thank you, Lord. And all of a sudden, it starts coming out of my mouth in tongues, and I hear it as this gibberish just coming out of my mouth, and I think to myself, like, what the heck is this? So I try to go back to, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Lord, but I couldn't. It keeps flowing out in tongues, and a warmth came over me head to toe, and an extreme feeling of love and joy throughout my whole body, like the most amazing feeling that I could ever possibly experience on this earth. I feel just like an intense warmth over head to toe, extreme feeling of love and joy, and I actually visualized the Holy Spirit coming into my heart. In that moment, I knew without a doubt that Jesus Christ was the Lord of my life, that God was real, that the Bible was true. And I remember driving home from Philadelphia about 45 minutes, the whole way just saying, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I ended up going to a Christian school in South Carolina, the South Carolina School of Leadership. And it's a very intense 9-month discipleship program. And one morning I was in prayer, normal prayer, thank you, Lord, for my family. Thank you for my health. And out of nowhere, I actually pictured a map of America with a man dragging a cross, walking across the country. And I knew in my heart that God was calling me to walk across the nation, dragging a crucifix. I knew it in my heart, but I said, Lord, that's crazy. I don't know if it's possible. Plus I have a cell phone bill, a car payment, car insurance, a loan payment. Well, I got my tax return back and it was exactly enough to pay my bills for the summer. And then I went to an evening service. And the token at the church service was a cross with a verse on it from Mark 8:34, where Jesus calls to the crowd together with his disciples and says, if you are to be my disciple, you must deny yourself and take up your cross and follow me. I bought a one-way ticket to California. When school ended, I just flew to Los Angeles. A church there gave me a cross, and I began my walk back across the country to South Carolina. I didn't have any money, any food, a map or compass or GPS, but I knew that the sun rose in the east and set in the west. So I just set off, keeping the sun in front of me during the day and behind me in the evening. And I thought it was gonna be horrible, sleeping outside every night, hungry every day. But 87 days, I didn't miss a single meal. Most nights I stayed in hotel rooms or people blessed me and took me into their homes. So I walked across America, starting from California to South Carolina. The trip took 87 days. I went through 8 pairs of shoes. Every pair was provided for, and every pair has a testimony of its own. But I thought it was gonna be a horrible summer, and it ended up being the best summer of my life.